Alright, so someone just gave me this Honda weed whacker here. It's in pretty good condition. I don't think he used it too much. Honda right there. Let's put this together and see if it'll run. Alright, that's what I must be missing a part here, because that's... That's fully tightened up. Alright, so there it is, I found it. Right there the whole time. Yeah, that's gotta be it. There, that's on there good now. Alright, now let's see if it'll start. So, it being a four stroke, let's check the oil. Alright, that's perfect. Right where it should be. Okay, primer. Oh no, look. I won't run. Yeah, see that split right there? Oh, it'll never run. Alright, let's try for a start here, so choke on. Doesn't like throttle. Okay, so let's get this carb off here. So I did just have it running there, but as soon as you touch the throttle, the thing died. So I just ordered a carburetor kit for it. That should fix this running issue. Alright, this is the carburetor now rebuilt. These, I guess I didn't really need those. Gave me extra or something, not sure, but let's go put that back on the machine. There, so now this should run pretty much perfectly now. Those new diaphragms in there. Alright, so the problem with running, I'm going to clear up the tank because it looks like the tank isn't the cleanest. Oh yeah, you see that's full of varnish. I bet you that fuel filter on it's not the cleanest. You see that? There's still dirt in there. That's why it's not running properly. It's almost like dirt. I don't know, the hose doesn't look too good either. So that's what was in the tank there. There's no water, it's just dirt. Looks like rust, but it isn't. Yeah, that was important to get that out. So this fuel filter here, I just took it off to clean it, and I soon realized this thing's pretty well clogged up. Not much fuel could get through here. So that probably explains why it wasn't running properly. Like it would start and die. This is probably the reason why. So I got the new one here. I mean, it's not the same, but it'll work. It's the same principle. Yeah, that fits better. Tank nice and cleaned out. Alright, so I'm going to replace this black fuel line here, believed to be the cause of the problem of it starving for fuel. There's my new fuel filter I put on. Gonna reuse that. Go. Take those clamps. Oh yeah, you see that? Yeah. See that right there? Yeah, that definitely needed to be replaced. So you cut an angle, like a sharp angle like that, that helps you to put it in this fuel port here. I'm gonna cut it there. There we go. Good times. Alright, let's put that back together here. So there's the old fuel line out of it. Now the reason why I didn't want to replace this at first, because this is the original fuel line that it came with from Japan. It looks like that. It's, you know, it's time to replace regardless of where it's from, you know. It's not looking good. Got some throttle. Try swapping the plug here. So this is it. I just took it out. It's a real small plug. I might have one on another engine. Be the same plug. This should fix this bike at some point. I'd say that runs better. So it was a spark plug the whole time. Alright, so here it was, thinking it was fuel related, but it was the spark plug that was causing the problem. Let's go try it out. Looks like there's grease still in there. Alright, so before I start using it, I want to change the oil in this. I don't know how old it is. So I just had it running for about 5 minutes. Kill switch still on. Pull it over a few times. It's perfect, right where it should be, right where the end of the threads are. So the plan is here, I'm just gonna try it out. You know, this pathway is a bit tight here. Let's see. I mean, it should be able to clear it out. I haven't used it before. that's what I did there. Yeah, works good. Just need to get the balance on this harness. Once you get that sorted, it'll be much easier to use, but it doesn't seem to like the brambles though. It's got different attachments for it, but the string works good on the weeds. Alright, this machine is now finished, working order, now ready to be put to work. And you can take the string trimmer off here and put a blade on for, that would have been better for the brambles I was cutting. You know, that would have sliced them up no problem. You see here, it just grabs it and wraps around, that's kind of what happens there.